Do you know that Israelites did not march around the city of Jericho 7 times, as we mostly hear? And there was a great reason behind what God instructed them to do. Let us understand the facts and the mystery behind it in this video. While learning about the wall of Jericho, we can come up with vital information. Actually, Yahweh did not tell Joshua to march 7 times around Jericho, but if we read carefully the instructions given by Yahweh to Joshua, it is written, "And the Lord said to Joshua, See, I have given Jericho into your hand, with its king and mighty men of valor. You shall march around the city, all the men of war, going around the city once. Thus shall you do for 6 days. 7 priests shall bear 7 trumpets of ram's horns before the ark. On the 7th day, you shall march around the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow the trumpets." So this clearly means that Yahweh instructed Joshua to march around Jericho once every day for 6 days. And on the 7th day, he instructed to march 7 times. Now if we add a single round each for every 6 days and 7 rounds on the 7th day, it will sum up to 13 rounds and not 7. But why Yahweh made Israelites do it? There has to be a reason and a lesson behind every instruction of God. Apostle Paul assures us, "For everything that is written in the past was written to teach us, so that through endurance and the encouragement of the scriptures we might have hope." Since many decades, the wall of Jericho has been compared to our problems. And the power and the might of God is being projected in the demolition of the wall, which portrays that God has supernatural and mighty power to demolish every strong wall of any problem which works in the life of those who trust in His name. But the incident of Jericho will portray this nature of God with extreme detail of how God plans everything, which is really amazing. Let us look into some facts about Jericho. Word Jericho in Hebrew means city of palms. Jericho is the oldest city of the world, and it is the lowest city on the earth, situated 275 meters or 900 feet below the sea level. Since it was located at the crossroads of 2 main travel routes, which were north-south route that ran through the Jordan Valley and an east-west route that connected the east side of the Jordan River with Jerusalem, the Samaritan cities and the coastal plain cities of the Mediterranean Sea. Therefore, the Israelites had no other option but to cross through Jericho. The city of Jericho is also known as Tel Jericho or Tel Es Sultan. The city was fortified with double walls. These double walls were enormous and overwhelming in size and strength. The walls were constructed of large stones at the base and mud bricks continuing upwards. The exterior wall's stone base was about 5 meter high or 15 feet tall, and the mud brick wall on top of it was another 8 meter or 25 feet tall, for a total of 13 meters or 40 feet. The width of the wall was 6 meter or 20 feet, and we know that Rahab's house was over the wall mentioned in Joshua chapter 2 verse 15. Thank you. we have come across the details about the Wall of Jericho from the decades of archaeological findings, which provided a proof that the Bible is authentic. But the most significant of all is the detail about how well did Yahweh plan everything with Israelites. The city of Jericho was actually the place of satanic worship where they used to sacrifice children and virgins, and it was also a center of many satanic rituals. This was the main reason why God told Israelites not to spare anyone except Rahab. Since the city was the fortress of Satan and his followers, the Israelites were head to head with Satan and his power, and that is why Yahweh himself intervened to destroy Satan's army and indicated that he is with his chosen people and their ever-present help, fortress and strong tower. If we pay proper attention to what God instructed Joshua, we will be surprised to see the facts and details in them. To understand this, we should look carefully at the Wall of Jericho. The width of the Wall of Jericho was 6 meters. We can notice that Yahweh instructed Israelites to march around Jericho once a day till 6 days. This means that the 6 rounds mentioned in Joshua chapter 6 verse 3 were actually for every single meter of the 6 meter width of the wall. The height of the wall was 13 meters. That means when Yahweh made Israelites to circle around Jericho a total of 13 times, it was for every meter of the height of the wall. The foundation of the Wall of Jericho was 6.7 meters. That means 6 rounds of 6 days and 7 rounds on the 7th day were for every meter and every inch. Joshua was a person who feared God, and he always humbled himself in front of the Lord. The city of Jericho was a big obstacle in front of Joshua and Israelites. But Joshua gave room for Yahweh to work in the midst of his crisis. He did not crib, disobey, murmur, or question. As a result of which, Yahweh revealed that may it be any obstacle or any problem, he will not let even an inch of it to remain. At these perilous times, everyone is facing some or the other problem. No one is spared. We should know that God gives his hardest battle to his strongest soldier, as he expects that his strongest soldier will fight well. And in our life, family, ministry, house, work, study, or wherever we have problem, if we have given the leash of control in the hands of God and trusting him for whatever he is doing, then he is more than able to destroy even an inch of that problem. And he will surely do, as he is in control. It may be that in order to demolish your Wall of Jericho, you may have to circle around it, go through it, face hardships, pray earnestly, lose money, or whatever. But if you have given the leash in the hands of God and believe and depend completely on him and his timing, then gather yourself, strengthen your faith, and remind yourself what Moses said to Israelites before parting the Red Sea. Moses said, "Be still and see the salvation of God." All the devices of Satan are going to be destroyed and demolished, even an inch of it. Because the Word of God promises, "The Lord is the one who will go before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. Do not be afraid or discouraged."